Memory Plus phone is very useful. You can personalise with photographs of family members, and then if someone wants to use it, they just pick it up as a normal phone and just press the button. So if they want to phone perhaps their GP, might have a picture of a cross on there, or perhaps it's the daughter, might have a picture of the daughter, and then it goes through automatically. There's a cover on it and it hides the buttons, which is quite useful, isn't it, at times?
It is, because people tend to remember they need to punch in a number, but they may not remember the number. Hence the idea of having photographs along the side is excellent, and you can then cover the numbers. So it would prompt the person to press the button rather than the numbers.
That sounds really good, actually, because especially now we've all got mobile phone numbers as well. Numbers are just so complicated, aren't they?
They are.
To remember. But also I quite like how simple it is to program. But you literally just press that button, put in the number. If you're programming this for one of your relatives, put in the number and then press the button that corresponds to that number. Job's done. It's really, really simple. And then, as you said, just click that back down and then all that complicated stuff's been done.
Yeah. There's also various volumes, so for people with hearing impairments.
Yeah. If you're actually talking about people being able to hear through the handset, then that can be controlled by this slider button here. So obviously the lower down it is, the quieter it is, but you can boost it up. But then if you've got somebody like my dear old Ma, who's as deaf as a post, you can actually press this button as well.
And does that program it to stay at that volume?
What you would need to do to program it to stay at that volume is actually just fix it with one of these buttons that are on the back. So if you were describing a scenario where somebody would be constantly fiddling with the things, and so you'd be resetting the volume that it was set at.
Yeah.
If you just set it yourself to what the required
standard
is.
Lock it, isn't it?
Yeah. Exactly. And then.
And it's hidden away as
well. It's hidden away, and then dear old Ma, in my case, could be fiddling to her heart's content. It's going to keep it at the setting
correct
that's
volume.
That's correct for her. Then on the side here as well, you can also see that there's another slider button that will go up and down, and that controls the ringer.
Yeah.
So it can really be personalised to meet the needs of the user that's actually using it.
Very useful device, that is, particularly the photographs on the front.
Yes, yeah.
That's really useful, a really useful idea.
And this clicks shut as well, so it can't be opened easily.
Yeah.
So it's really good, isn't it? Because we get a lot of people, family carers, saying that they're getting inappropriate phone calls. But if you just limit to four people, that's quite good. And you can change it. So if, say, your mum is phoning her daughter a lot, you can give the daughter a rest and reprogram it for her son instead.
Brilliant.